Yes, sir. REZ-2021-30 for the Interstate Land Management LLC. This is a request to R1, from R1, low density residential to RA, residential agricultural, on approximately 66 acres, depicted here across multiple lots. Motivation is, again, request for the applicant to grow some hay and embark on agricultural activities not normally allowed in R1 zoning. Currently, you can see it's surrounded by R1 zoning. For the character area, it is a suburban character area, and its comprehensive plan does allow for RA zoning. In this case, it was rezoned to R1 at the adoption of the ULDC back in 2006, mainly because of proximity to water and sewer and the surrounding residential development at that time. In addition, the surrounding zoning of R1 ranges from 1 acre to 7 acres, and the adjacent RA zoning slightly to the south. You note two large properties here. Again, you can see the properties better outlined here that are requesting to be combined and rezoned to RA for agricultural purposes. And again, picture of the property in its current state. I believe the applicant is here to speak for any additional questions about these intentions with this property.
Thank you, J.D.
Commissioners,
any questions for staff on this case?
I got a question. I think you're reading it wrong or it's backwards on this. It says it's currently RA and you're changing it to low density R1.
Is that? Yes, sir. That is.
That's incorrect.
It is currently R1 and the request is RA.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Any other questions from the commissioners for staff? Well, then we'll open the public hearing portion on this case. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? Please come forward. State your name and address for the record, please.
Bobby Brodkin, 1929 Seminole Drive. I'm one of the owners of Interstate Land Management. Several reasons I'm trying to do this. When I bought the land, part of it already had a farm number on it. So my understanding was it was a farm, but I found out later it was R1. So trying to get it changed back to an ag. We got already got grass growing on it. Plus, I don't have no way of building a hay shed or a shelter for my equipment because I'm R1. So this is one of the reasons that we're trying to get it change where we can build more shed and stuff on the property.
Any commissions, any questions for Mr. Brogdon? Commissioners? Thank you, sir. Anyone else who would like to speak in favor of this case, please come forward. Is there anyone here who would like to speak against this case? Public hearing portion on this case is now closed. Any other discussion among the commissioners on this? If not, I'll call for a motion.
I have a quick question.
Oh, sir.
This area that is not included, is that already RA, and is that part of the landowner's property, or is that just not a part of this?
Can you be a little more specific on which part?
On the north,
between the two
east corner, there's a block, and then there's two blocks that surround that or that are not outlined, and then a smaller block. Is that all part of the same piece of property, or
only the parcels outlined in blue on this slide are the property owners in question behind them to RA. The other properties are R1.
Jay, I'm just curious, what would stop the owner from building an equipment shed or a hay storage shed in this R1 facility?
Nothing in particular about the zoning. Typically, accessory structures like that are zoned or allowed built on the acreage. But for agricultural uses, an agricultural zoning better fits rather than a residential in this case.
Any other questions, Commissioner? Then I'll entertain a motion.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Wallace.
Regarding this case, REZ-2021-30, it's a request to rezone this property from low density residential to residential agriculture, which is a down zone, which is always plan be complied with the comprehensive plan. I'd like to make a motion that we recommend approval.
Thank you. There's a motion for approval from Commissioner Wiles. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Commissioner Webb. All those in favor, raise your hand. Against? That was unanimous, Chair.
Thank you.